Gracehill Moravian Church, built in the mid-18th century in Ballymena, is at the heart of Northern Ireland's first designated conservation area. Raymond Kitson is the volunteer property steward responsible for the maintenance of this Grade A listed building. He oversees all the work to preserve the unique structure and provides continuous employment for craftspeople skilled in historic building techniques.
I see myself as a custodian of the bricks and mortar here in Gracehill Moravian Church. The church is dating back to 1759. Lord O'Neill leased the land to like-minded Moravians, and at that time the church in 1759 was formed. The conservation area was given to Gracehill back in 1975. It was the first in Northern Ireland. So the DOE at that time seen and recognised the beauty, character and the charm that this village had. So the first conservation area, which we're extremely proud of, and it's an accolade we're very proud to have. This is, I don't know if my minister would agree, but this is like our Bible within the construction end of things. I'm from a building background, so this tells me exactly what the issues are and tells me exactly a programme of works that's going to ensure that it is dealt with. Any given works is done through a planned cyclical programme. If you do not maintain or carry out maintenance as you go along, then you will run into major problems in years to come. We needed a new church roof. You often hear that from one church to another, need a church roof. We were no different. The problems that we had here was slates literally were slipping. Now, these slates in the church are huge. In fact, to pick up a single slate on your own is challenging. So these slates, when they do come loose, they were quite dangerous. We were very fortunate in obtaining 13 funders who helped us with £150,000 of a grant. We took the opportunity to re-plaster, re-render walls and so forth, not just today's chemicals that they would have in cement and so forth, with lime, back into the original authentic techniques that they used back in the day. All these windows in here were all replaced. We, where possible, we reused all the glass and timbers as well. So it's as back to as original as what we could possibly have. The church is open to the public and we welcome visitors. We organise planned tours. We have got a range of different tour guides who actually look after the village, and they have a wealth of knowledge of the history. We've got a huge array of archives in our store in the Cynic Hall, which is the hall behind us there. We've just completed another major restoration in the church. You may notice in the background there, the organ. The organ dates back from 1829, and it was done by a Scotland firm, McDonald's. And they did an excellent job on it. It's important for not only the building, but the people who live here and the people who attend this church. They are very proud people of their heritage, and they would not like to see any of it being removed or declined in any way.